Today I'm going to show you how I made these window covers for my Toyota Matrix to keep me stealthy as well as cool. I start by putting the bottom in and fitting it between this piece of trim and the edge of the window on this side. Slide it in there, get it into position, and just push it in. And it stays in all by itself. Now the Reflectix is going to reflect the sunshine that is shining down on my car quite strongly right now and reflect the heat away from the car, which will help to keep the interior of my car just a little bit cooler. Now we're on the passenger side of the car and we're going to face the black side out to make me stealthy. So you put the bottom in first, push up at the top and all around the edges. When you're in stealth mode, you want to make sure that there is no light escaping from your windows if you have a light on inside. To remove these from the window, I built in a handle that all you have to do is pull on the handle and out pops the window cover. I store these underneath my mattress during the day. They're not in the way. They stay nice and flat, and it's easy enough for me to take them out and put them in the windows before I go into stealth mode. To make these window covers, you're going to need paper of some kind or tin foil to make your pattern, a roll of Reflectix. Make sure you measure the width of your windows before you buy your Reflectix. If you need a wider Reflectix, you can buy it wider. You can also tape pieces together to make it wider. You'll also need some black duct tape, a pair of scissors, a razor knife, piece of chalk, a felt pen or other kind of pen, some spray adhesive. For the side windows, you'll need foam board. This is black foam board that I picked up at a dollar store for $1.75 a sheet, and that's in Canadian. Most craft stores, dollar stores, Staples probably would carry this stuff. It's black on both sides. And for the back window, you'll need some black fabric. To make the templates for your car windows, there are two different methods that I've tried, and both of them work pretty good. It really just depends on what you prefer to use, what you might have on hand, and you might want to try both just to see which is easiest for you. The first one that I tried was the tinfoil method. You just get a roll of tinfoil, and you can see on this one, I had to masking tape two pieces of tinfoil together to make it wide enough for the back seat windows. Put it onto the window and start pressing very gently because you don't want to break through the foil. I was able to then just fold the edges in and created a pattern for my back passenger windows. I have a roll of masking paper, but you can use any kind of paper. You can use a thin cardboard, you can use school writing paper. Just stick pieces together so that you've got a piece that is the size of the window that you want to cover. Through the window, I can see the size of the piece that I'm going to need. I'm going to need to make the template inside the car, but I can cut the piece of paper for the window outside the car. This is the window that I'm going to use to make the template. First of all, I'm going to put some masking tape on the back of the piece of paper to hold it in place on the window. I'm not going to push on it really hard. I just don't want it to slip while I'm making my pattern. So making sure that the paper is going to cover all of the window, stick your tape to the window. Then begin to push the paper into the shape of the window. You can also use a pair of scissors to cut off some of the bulk paper around the edges that isn't going to be required for the pattern. I find starting with the top and then pushing in the bottom kind of centers your paper and helps you to get it started. Start folding the paper down so that it's right at the edge of where you want your cover to be. So now basically I have the shape of my window pressed into with my fingernails, or you could use, you don't want to use something sharp, but something that will actually give you a little bit of a crease there. And then when you take it out, you actually have the shape of your window pressed into your paper. And then you can just cut it out. It doesn't have to be perfect because I do have a way to fix any imperfections around the window edge. Every time you make a cut, it's a good idea to put it back in the window and see how close you are. So I can see I can cut off more in this corner and up there. This looks pretty good. So now I can take this pattern and go and trace it out on my cover materials. I'll be making two of them, and they are reversible for both sides, depending on what side of the material you want facing out. The mosquitoes are coming out in full force at the moment. The sun's just gone down, so I'm going to work, do this as quickly as possible so I don't get too eaten up. You need the chalk to trace the pattern on the black foam board. This works much better to cut if you use a razor knife rather than a pair of scissors. So now we have two pieces, one for each side. So after a few adjustments, this now fits in here quite nicely. You don't need to worry about little places like this because we're going to remedy that in a few steps. So one of the things about this foam board is that it's quite stiff, and once it's pushed in there, there's really no way you can pull it back out. That's where I find a fork comes in handy. If you have one of those with you, you can stick it underneath there and pull it out. But we're going to remedy that too, so stick with me. So what I'm going to do, instead of cutting out the Reflectix, I'm actually going to spray the Reflectix, because this is just going to be a scrap piece anyway. I'm going to spray it with my adhesive and then stick the pieces that I've got cut out for the windows on here and then cut around them. So it kind of takes care of two steps in one step. Make sure when you put these on that they're actually facing opposite ways, because they're going to be for different sides of the windows. If you did them both facing the same way, you'd end up with two for the same window. So now I can cut them apart and cut them out. To make the handles like the ones I put on my blinds, you'll need a piece of duct tape about 3 or 4 inches long. You fold it in half, but only attach the fold together. You want the two ends to be separate. You take those two ends and you stick them to whichever side you're making the handle for. And there you go. So we've moved inside to finish these off because I was getting bitten to bits by the mosquitoes. They were just going crazy. So we're going to finish these off. We've got the handles on both sides. To finish them off, well, it's kind of the second to last step. So we take some black duct tape and rip off a piece or cut off a piece that is long enough to cover one side of the blind. Don't try to do the whole thing in one fell swoop because you'll just get yourself all in a sticky mess. Taking the window cover and placing the tape on it so that it is covering the edge, but it's going to wrap around to the other side. Doing it this way, you can see how much you've got left sticking out from behind. So doing that, giving a little bit of a pat there, but you don't want to stick it all the way until you've got it in place, like so. Smoothing that down so it's all stuck on there, and then folding this side over around the edge. So now you're sealing off the edge of the window cover, so there's less chance of it coming apart, as well as protecting the edges, so as you're pushing it in and out of the window, it's not destroying the edges of the foam board or the edges of the Reflectix. I don't think the edges of the Reflectix are too much of an issue, but the foam board I think would be. And when you get to the end here, rather than trying to go around the corner with it, just squeeze it off on the end with your scissors, just cutting it off. Then you go to your next side. So now we have both of the back windows covered, and we're going to go out and fit them in. So I've got the one on this side and the one on the other side put in, but I'm going to show you where there's potential for light to come through and give away any kind of stealthiness that you're trying to go for if you're parking in a place where you're not really probably supposed to be parking overnight, but you want to block all the light that's coming out of the back of your car, camper, or your van, or whatever, because if somebody walks by and they see, you know, a little bit of light along the top of your window, it's going to give you away. And to avoid getting that knock from a person in authority who has the right to tell you to move on, you want to make sure that there is no light coming through from inside your car or your van that's going to give you away. So I'll show you up close where there is the potential for some light to show through. This is the window on the passenger side, and if you look right up here, you can see that's actually light coming through above the top of the cover there. And down the bottom here, there is, you can see the little bit of a blue glow right there, and right here, that's also where light is coming in from outside. So if light can come in, light can also go out. And I'll show you on the other side, it's a lot worse on the other side, so I'll show you that too. So up here, it's pretty obvious. You can see right through there, and down the bottom here, there's lots of light coming in there. So this one didn't fit as well. I can still fix that, and I'll show you how easy it is to do that. So there's the blind that had a little bit of light coming in through up here and a little bit of light coming in down the bottom. And I'm going to extend the edges of those areas with another piece of duct tape, and I'll show you how to apply it so that it covers up those possible light leaks. I take a piece of black duct tape. I cut it about the same size as that edge up there. So you, instead of wrapping it around the top this time, we're going to extend it above the top. So I'm going up to the top, and then on the other side, you can see how much of the tape sticks up there. I'm going to fold it over and stick it just to the top of the window cover here, and just right at the top there. Duct tape is so sticky that it doesn't really need to grab too much of the surface to stay stuck, and it's not really going to be putting any pressure on this part of the tape. So now I've got it folded over. It's not very neat. You can see it's kind of crumply there, but it doesn't matter. And then I'm squeezing it all together so the duct tape is sticking to itself, and it's created an extension on the top of the window blind. Now I can stick it back in and show you how much better that this little fin covers. There's now no light coming in through up here at all. This fin folds over and fills in the space that had light coming through. Now there's absolutely no light coming in anywhere along here, and the sun is shining right on this side of the car. So if there was light coming in, you'd be able to see it. The last thing I want to do with these blinds is make it so that the back windows open. I can fold down the top part of this so that it will allow the air to come in. I have the rain guards that hang down about that far below the top of the window. So I would like to be able to open my window up at least that much. Now that's going to take away the stealthiness, I guess, if I have lights on in the car at night. You're going to be able to see the glow of the light coming out through the rain guard because it's not a solid color, it's like a pinky purple clear color. So I would only be doing this if I was feeling okay about where I was stealth camping, or if I was going to sleep and I wasn't going to have any lights on anyway, and then I could lower the windows down and make these so that they will allow the air to come in, because the way they are right now, they're solid and they're not going to let any air circulate. So this is what I'm going to do to remedy that. So to do this, I need to have a razor knife again, a straight edge to cut along, and my black duct tape So the screen is in the window like this, and this part here is going to fold over towards the shiny side like a hinge. So I'm going to cut from the black side.
Right there. And there. It doesn't have to be perfectly straight, but at least if it's close.
So now what I'm doing is I'm going to cut through all of the layers except the last layer of the reflectix. So it's the side of the reflectix that is actually the side that you see on the other side. And the idea behind that is that that will create a bit of a hinge. So I'm going to cut through here, not quite as deep as I think I need to, and fold it over. Now, looking at it this way, I think you can see the foam board in there. That's on both sides. I haven't cut through the reflectix at all yet, so I'm going to cut another time, but a little bit deeper this time, and try to gauge it so that I am cutting through the bubbles in the reflectix and not all the way through. So now I'm opening it up, and you can see here in here is the bubble wrap right in there. And I've cut through the top layer, or the inside layer of the reflectix, but left the outside layer intact. Then, flipping it over, you can see I now have a hinge along here, so that this layer of reflectix doesn't get worn through or thin out. I'm adding a layer of duct tape to that hinge area, just to give it some strength, because it's going to get folded back and forth, and it still hinges back and forth. And of course, the more I fold it, the happier it's going to be about doing that. Now, I also need to add something to the back of this so that when I fold it down, it stays down and doesn't just flip back up and cover up the open window space. So what I'm going to use is a piece of Velcro, and this Velcro is super duper strong. It's hard to get the backing off of this Velcro. It's a lot of fiddling to get it off because it's really sticky on the back. So we'll just fast forward through the fiddly part of me trying to get the backing off of this Velcro and get to the part where I actually use it. I finally had to use my teeth to get enough of a hold on this tape to pull them apart. It's just ridiculously strong. I mean, it's good, but it's really, really strong. So I stick that one up there, and this one, I've got to get the back off this one now. If you need some ridiculously strong Velcro strips, I'll leave a link down below where you can find it on Amazon. Now I take this half and stick it on top of the other half, just so I know I'm putting it in the right place when it folds over. So we fold it down. Let it squish for a little while. I'm not sure if this is the same as the command strips where you have to hold it in place for a while, but we'll go with that. And you can see it's staying down. And I can undo it, stick it back down. So now the window will stay free of being cluttered up by this and allow the air to circulate. So there's the reflectix all put in for stealth mode with our new hinge side up there. You can see it still fits nicely in there. Might put another little tab on this part here to bring it down. That is now an open window space. This is still a small enough space through here that Gracie can't get out. So if I don't put the screens on, if I'm in a place where it's not buggy, Gracie still can't get out of here, which is always my main concern, is her safety. Wanting to close it up. And there we go. That works pretty good. So now, the last window that I need to do now, I may do some for the front two side windows eventually, but for now I need to do this back window in privacy stealth mode as well as reflectix. So again, I'm going to use the reflectix, but this time, because this is such a weird window with these things for the windshield wipers and the brake light, and it has these struts for the window opening and closing, like they hold the window up. I'm going to just use the Reflectix instead of making a paper pattern. I already tried that and it was a complete disaster. Didn't help that it was a little bit windy. So I'm going to use the Reflectix and hopefully that will be a better way to do it. And what I found is, just by measuring, is this window is a little bit wider than my narrower Reflectix. I have the wider Reflectix, but cutting a piece that's just a little bit wider than this seems like a waste for the larger Reflectix. So I'm going to cut out with this one and then we'll adapt it around the edges with the duct tape like I did for the other side window covers. So let's see how this works. I'm first going to cut out a piece that will cover the whole back window and then we'll start making it fit. Because of these struts back here, I can't use the black foam board because it's not flexible. I couldn't cut around here and have the foam go around the other side and wrap around it kind of thing. So I'm just going to use this and then I'm going to use some black fabric stuck to the back side of it for the stealth mode type cover. So get this started. So now I can start doing a little bit of trimming. So just cutting little bits to make the Reflectix exactly lie flat against the window. Much easier than the paper, holy moly. Now I'm going to do these corners so I can get it fitted in so I'll be able to cut around the window struts. I've pushed the Reflectix into the edge of the window and now I'm going to use my felt pen to just trace out a line where that fold is so when I take it off I'll be able to see that and cut around it. So now I can pull this out and cut along the line that I've made, show you, with the felt pen. I'm going to cut it a little bit bigger than the line, just so it gives me a little bit of wiggle room. So then I'm going to put it back in, double check. So now I need to cut in from these, around these window struts where they attach to the window. And what I'm going to do is just cut from the side, which will be coming in from this side over here, to the window strut. I'll be able to wrap the Reflectix around this thing when I put it on. And even if I have to put a piece of Velcro on there or something like that to hold it closed nice and tight, I can do that. But that's how I'm going to get around this particular strut, is from the side over here. So I'm going to start cutting to the window strut. I'll make a bit of a star shape with my cut around where that thing attaches to the window, just so it will, the Reflectix will bend up around it. I can always add duct tape around it to firm it up again. So now I'm able to tuck the rest of the Reflectix up past where the strut attaches to the window. Tuck that all in so I can get my line, get my pen again, and making sure that's tucked right in there, draw in my line, and I'm going to do with the other side as well before I start to cut that out. So now I can work on where the brake light is and where the window washer wiper thing is. Again, I'm going to use my felt pen to trace around that shape of the brake light, making sure that where the edge of the brake light is right up there, but it's quite flat, so making it a little bit bigger. I'll show you up here where the window actually comes through, because the reflectix was just a little tiny bit not big enough. So you can see up there, and on this side up there, it's just a little tiny bit, but that's really the only place it wasn't wide enough. I need to cover the other side with the black fabric, and I'm just realizing that my window back here is not symmetrical. It's not like I can cut it in half and have both sides be the same because of this thing. So what I'm going to have to do is cut two of these, I guess, one for stealth and one for just reflectix. I could also use just one of those ones that you use in the front windshield to cover this back window for when it's hot. I may just do that. Yeah, I'm probably gonna go with that for now. If I find that doesn't work and it doesn't stay up properly or whatever, I'll make another one of these. I do actually have just enough to make another one. But for now, I need to cover the other side of this one with black fabric and then start fitting it in a little bit better. I used a black sheet that I picked up at a secondhand store for a couple dollars to cut out a piece of black fabric that will just cover the reflectix. It doesn't need to be cut to the shape of the reflectix until I glue it on. It's much easier to do that after you've glued it on. And I'm first going to use my Elmer's spray adhesive, which sticks to foil, which is good for using with reflectix. This stuff, you don't have to wait for it to get tacky. You need to get it on fairly quickly. I'm going to take the fabric, make sure there's nothing, no dog hair or something stuck to the other side, and just drape it over the top and try to get it as smooth as possible before it sticks down. When I turn it over, you can see that I just need to cut out around the edge of the reflectix. So I'm going to put this in the window and then we'll check to see how well it's fitting and also how it looks from the outside. I don't know if you can see through all the pollen. That looks pretty good. So I'm going to do the same thing with this window cover as I did with the side one, where I frame it with the black duct tape. That will keep the sides from coming apart or ripping or getting worn out. I'll take it section by section, rather than trying to do one long route around. I'm just going to do it little bit by little bit with the duct tape. So now it's all taped around the edges, as well as where it goes around the wheel struts. And I'm going to put it back in to make double sure again that it actually still fits. That looks pretty good. I still need to add a little bit of height on either side of the windshield wiper compartment. So I'm going to do that with some duct tape and make the little fins above or outside of the cover like I did with the other ones. That looks pretty good. Quite happy with that. I may find that I need to do something around the holes that the struts come through. But for now, I'm just going to leave it and see how that plays out. I may need to wrap it in something. I'll run a test tonight and show you how to see how lightproof it is. I'll wait till it gets dark and then I'll come out. I'll brave the bugs and I'll come out and turn the lights on inside the car and we'll see how much light is coming out around the blinds that I've made. I'm going to be making a curtain for the front of the car that will go behind the back seats next. And whether I get that made before I actually go out on my camping trip or do that when I get back. I'm not sure if I'm gonna have time or not, but I do have a way to string a curtain up there that will make it so that the front seat is completely cut off from the back and will be light proof as well. So I'm hoping it's going to work. I have it all in my head, but right now I'm quite happy with these blinds and we're gonna test them out tonight. So I'm outside and it is dark and there's the car and I'm just going to shut off the camera light so you can see the tail light there. And going up to the back window here, that's a reflection, that light down there. No light coming through this back window. Of course, it's completely black, so it's not really showing you much, but it is showing you that there is no light coming in. This is the back window. That's my shadow coming across there. This is the back driver's side window. No light coming through there. That's the reflection of the porch light in the window. But there's no light escaping anywhere that I can see. And I'm going to go around to the other side. And again, not even a sliver of light coming out these. So now I'm going to open up the back and you can see what is in the back of the